not only to come to him, but to go for him. Your mission and my mission is really to signify the presence of the Lord. Jesus repeated, the Bible says, five times in five different ways and in five different books of the Bible. He said, I really want you to get this. See, you can understand every time you exemplify the word of God, it gives you power to your understanding.
Amen.
In other words, it makes you.
Yes.
I don't mean it pushes you into something, but it directs you in this world to be a better soldier and not a difficult soldier.
Uh-huh.
In other words, God has allowed you and I to accept the mission that we want to believe in the mission of him, to believe in his word, and to believe in the Bible and the word of God, then your mission will become simple, and it won't be mind-boggling anymore.
Uh-huh.
See, fulfilling your mission is your life in this world. Not only
Jesus,
you're working to the grace of God, but you're easing your pain as you go through this world.
Mm-hmm.
Your mission is a continuation of Jesus' mission on earth.
Mm-hmm.
We're doing as Jesus did as he walked as a natural man on this earth. Uh-huh. And as his followers, we're to continue what Jesus started. The Bible says Jesus called us not only to go to him, but to remain in his presence. And every time you bring the word of God into your life, you're increasing who you are in God. God would have you to read the 23rd Psalm and not remind you that the Lord is my shepherd. And yes, God allows you to read those verses that it would entangle your spirit. It would give you power to make it in this life. And understand, your mission is really a privilege. In other words, he gives you and I power to get more strength through his word. He gives you power to call it the way it ought to be in your life. In other words, God won't just use you and not protect you. He won't just use you and not keep you. He won't just allow you to go through and not strengthen you. God allows you this mission that you will be all right and working together with God.
Yes,
amen.
See, Brother Troy, Jesus has secured our salvation, put us in his family, gave us his spirit, and made us in his own image.
Yes.
Oh, I call that a privilege. What you call it?
Yes.
The Bible says we are Christ's representatives. God used us to persuade men and women to drop their differences in his entire word and come into God's work of making things right between them. We're speaking for Christ himself. In other words, God wants to use you as a common denominator. He wants to use you to be able to speak truth. He wants to use you to be able to speak peace. Telling others how they can have eternal life is the greatest thing you and I can do for God. How in the world can we worry about getting to heaven when we don't want to do right? How in the world do we want to worry about seeing Jesus one day and we're living like we're in hell? How in the world and we've not accepted our own sins and we have not asked God to forgive us for our own sins? We just continue to keep on keeping on. Somebody else say glory up in here. Has some kind of sickness, and you know because you know what the word of God says about sickness. God gives you an opportunity to share.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
God gives you the opportunity to get them away from their life-saving situation.
Yeah.
God allows you to come and talk to them about what the Bible says about healing. Now, in other words, God will put in front of you your mission. Now, if you're willing to take charge, God will put your mission right in front of you. And many of us run over our missions every day. It's all about me. It's all about what I want and how I feel. But that's not a mission. Because see, a mission is going to cause you to sacrifice. The mission is going to cause you to go through some situations. The mission is going to cause some hiccups in your life. But I come here tonight to tell you to hold up your head. Doesn't matter what you've been through with. Doesn't matter what you're going through with even tonight. God is still able to use you. I said he's still able to front you. He's still able to carry you through. He's still able to make everything all right. You just got to agree, Lord, I want my mission. I want to be used by you, Lord. I want to complete this journey, God. I want you to take me where I need to go, God. In other words, my soul says, yes, Lord. Until you are able to say, yes, Lord. You can't lose it. Till you're able to say, yes, Lord, I'll do your will. I'll go where you want me to go. I say what you want me to say. See, until you're able to demonstrate the love of God from your own heart. And be that man and be that woman God has brought you to be. It ain't no time to be thinking about who you love and who you don't love. Who you like and who you don't like. See, God will put you in a hard position sometimes. Where some folks it's hard to love. Because of exemplify love and how they give love and how they bring love. It's hard to love the hell out of some people. But when you're on a real mission, you don't see to that stuff. Because I'm going for what I know. In other words, I'm going for broke. I'm going to love her. I'm going to love him if they don't love me back. Because I'm looking for God's salvation. I ain't got time for why you don't love. I want you to get what I get. I want you to feel what I feel. That's the mission. That's a hard mission to get on. I come to help somebody. Oh, it's a hard mission. You know somebody lied on you. Little rolling eyes at you. And you got to say, oh, Lord have mercy. Yes, you got to go and do it. And keep it moving. See, your mission gives your life true meaning. See, what you find yourself doing, if you don't have a true meaning to it, then you really can't trust who you are in God. Come on, somebody. Your best must be said through you. My best is yet to come. In other words, you've got no time to doubt God. Because you're waiting on the best from the Lord. The best use of life is spent on something that's going to outlast where you've been. And this is the truth. See, we got to stop evaluating ourselves on where we've been. And what failures we had. That was then. My now is greater than that. Yes, Lord. Amen. Listen, you can't pin that hair out there. That's why you got to stop putting commas and put periods. Comma simply means I'll be back. Period means I'm finished.
That's right.
Amen.
Good word.
Yeah, you won't go back to commas. I ain't go back to no commas.
Come on, Bishop.
See, commas will mess you up. That means that you're still hanging out there in that spirit.
Jesus.
Hello, somebody.
Amen.
If you want to be blessed by God, Even tonight, you got to put a period and be done with it, because the truth is the only thing the kingdom of God is going to last. Everything else will eventually vanish. That is why we must live perfectly in the Lord. In other words, you ought to be life driven to the presence of God. Not only that, you need to learn how to commit to worship, fellowship, spiritual growth, ministry, fulfilling our mission on earth. In other words, and then you will know that it will last forever.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
We fail to fulfill our God's given mission on earth, then you will have to waste your whole life. Paul said, my life is worth nothing unless I use it for doing the work assigned me by the Lord Jesus Christ. The work of telling others that good news about the good news about God's wonderfulness and his kindness and his pure love. That is the only thing God requires from you, to talk about kindness and love. If you learn how to talk about kindness and love, then kindness and love will fall upon you. Talk about love.
Yes, yes.
You say, oh, how I love God. You got to love more than him.
Amen.
Matter of fact, you can't even love him.
Amen.
You don't know him without knowing your brothers and sisters. Uh-huh. Because he only shows up in our brothers and sisters.
Uh-huh.
Come on, somebody.
Uh-huh.
He only shows up in each of us.
Uh-huh.
And that's the only thing you got to love.
Yeah.
Oh, how I love the Lord. How you gonna love the Lord? You don't even know him.
Come on.
If you hadn't loved mother, you hadn't loved Evangelist Ruff, you hadn't loved Brother Troy, you hadn't loved sister, preacher lady here, brother musician, brother drummer, sister Jada. You hadn't loved any of these people. You got hate in your heart against any of these people. You blaspheme.
Right.
You're finished. You're through. I know sometimes people, the natural side frustrates you, but you can't look at the natural side. You got to look at the spiritual side, and when God is finally finished, he'll do something with it. Some processes in life you can't handle. You just got to get in place and stay in place.
Amen.
Jesus. Uh-huh. It's your mission. Listen, your mission has some curves in it that you can't handle or deal with. That's why God said, go, I'll go with you.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
You sitting there complaining. God gave you a hard assignment now. I'm telling you. I'm telling you what I know, not what I heard.
Amen.
God will give you a rough assignment.
Amen.
But Lord, when you get ready to bless you.
Yes,
good God Almighty.
Yes, Lord.
Some of us want to know why God hadn't visited. Look at your assignments.
Amen.
I don't worry about when people do me wrong.
Mm-hmm.
You done to me, you did to God.
That's right.
Amen. I don't get mixed up and get bit out of shape when folks say to me, but yeah, I don't care about that.
Amen.
Period. You have to teach yourself to have that quality.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You get mad, or I ain't going down that street because she made me look. I'm glad she didn't look. I'm still right.
Amen. Come on.
Make me go the wrong way because of or who you think you are. I'm coming right to your front door.
Amen.
In other words, you got to learn to live this thing to the fullest, people of God.
Mm-hmm.
Not only be thankful, but be grateful.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
I ain't upset my day.
Mm-hmm.
The last month, I spent some secure, quiet hours. I hear it, I don't hear no more.
Amen.
I know. I used to respond to everything I hear. I quit.
Amen. Unplug.
And I go home, but yeah, I unplug.
Amen.
You got to.
Yeah.
And wait for God to come to your door.
Amen.
He's coming. He's already there.
I got
just wait for the knock.
Amen.
Learn how to take some stuff.
Yes.
Don't get mad and upset. Because you're dealing with the spiritual side and you're dealing with the natural side. Unfortunately, you'd be more you dealing with on the natural than spiritual. It's okay.
Yeah.
It's all right. Mm-hmm. That's when you know you need some more medication of God's word.
Yes.
When you see you can't take this or you can't take that, you need some more word. Mm-hmm. That means you're not saved. That means you got some tenderness going on. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You got some tenderness going on that's not going your way, but it will go your way.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody said, thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
In other words, get yourself a willing spirit.
Yes.
Fix it.
Amen.
Fix it. Don't wait to fix it. Don't wait to New Year's resolution. Fix it now. God will.
Uh-huh.
One thing about God, he's not a seal of God, Brother Ben. When he get ready to fix it, he'll fix it right now.
Yeah.
And I believe in a right now God.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, Lord.
I believe in a right now God.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah up in here.
Yes, Lord.
God will do it. Oh, he'll do it. I got a mission.
Yeah.
Not only do I have a mission, but I'm on a mission. Somebody said glory to his name. See, if you fail to fulfill your God's given mission on earth, you have wasted your whole life.
Yeah.
There are people who have planted whom only you'll be able to reach. Because of where you live and what God has made you to be. If just one person would be in heaven because of you, your life would have made a difference on this earth. Start looking around at your personal mission and pray unto God. God who will put your life in a position where he can use you 24/7. And God's timetable for history must include you. In other words, it's time to stand up and represent that I want the Lord to use me. I want the Lord to rebuke my old assignment and give me the assignment that he can use. I want the Lord to make a difference in my life. Doesn't matter what I've been through with. Doesn't matter how much my spirit been broken. Doesn't matter how many lies been told on me. But I'm going to lift up my head. Tell the Lord, Lord, I thank you for using me as a servant. Lord, I thank you for letting everything be all right. Lord, I thank you for healing my body. Lord, I thank you for blessing my family. Lord, I thank you for the mission. For the mission you have with me on and I. And finally, you must understand tonight that to serve on the mission, there's a cost to fulfill your mission. You're going to go through some stuff. Or you're going to see some stuff that you don't understand. But to fulfill your mission, it will require that you abound by the word of the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Not only that, sometimes you got to abandon your own assignment,
yeah,
your own agenda,
yeah,
and accept the agenda of God for your life.
Mm-hmm.
You can't just tick-tack and tick-tack and think it's going to work. But all things you like to do with your life, sometimes you got to put them on the back burner and wait on the Lord. Not only wait on the Lord, but trust in the Lord. You must say like Jesus said, Father, I want your will, not mine. Sometimes you got to continue to pray to the Lord. Lord, I want your will, not my will. I want your will to be done right here on earth with me, Lord. Sometimes you got to say it seven times. You yield your rights, expectations. You yield your dreams. You yield your plans. You yield your affirmation. Not only that, you yield yourself unto the Lord. In other words, your ambition become nothing to him. You stop praying selfish prayers like, God, bless what I want me to do. Lord, I want you to go ahead. Lord, I want you to bless me with a house. I want you to bless me with a car. Lord, I want you to bless me with a job. That's not a mission. That's not a mission. That's self-centered. That's the eyes of the spirit. That's the eyes of disease. That's a cost to fulfill your mission. Somebody else said, Lord have mercy. If you will commit to fulfilling your mission in life, no matter what it costs you, if you know that, you know that, you know that there's almost nothing God won't do for a man or woman who is committed to serving the kingdom of God. Jesus has promised God will give you all you need from day to day if you live for him and make the kingdom of God your primary concern. Anybody?
Amen.
Your only concern.
Amen.
Blessings are dropping your nest you never thought would come.
My God.
All you got to do is look up.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
All you got to do is look and live.
Yes,
and the Lord will deliver.
Amen.
Jenny, he'll deliver before you even think about it. I can't hear nobody tonight. God will do it. I declare he'll do it. One more for Jesus. I'm going home tonight. My mission is on. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
See, if you intend to be who you are in the Lord for the rest of your life, then you focus. You put your focus on him, not who, not him, not her, but on Jesus.
Amen.
I just believe, brother, when Jesus gets tired of people messing with me, he move them.
Amen.
He will. He move them. I believe that. Not only do I believe, I see it quite often. But you got to trust him.
Yeah.
Not just every day, but till you die.
Jesus.
You got to think about your purpose in God.
Yeah.
Who gave you this heart of righteousness? Who gave you this joy? Who gave you this peace?
Yeah.
You can't give yourself no peace.
Okay.
You can have all the money in the world, it'll soon be gone.
Hallelujah.
Amen. No, ain't mine of peace. Don't believe, go by the nursery home down the street, the folks are millionaire level. They ain't know the millionaire. They could buy it, they wouldn't be in there. I can't hear nobody.
Yes,
amen.
Everything's in escrow. Everybody else spend their money but them. God is awesome.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
God is, oh my God.
Yes, he is.
That's why you, listen, you got to include him in who you are, because I need a potato.
Yes, my God.
You got to include God where you're going.
All right, man.
Sometimes you just got to sit down and talk to him. I do. Just sit down and say, what you say? I ain't talking to you. I'm the Lord. Just sit down and talk to him like a natural man. I don't care if you think you're losing your mind. It's your mind. Figure out your mission. And then invite God in. And your life will be such a plentiful that you won't even remember when and where. All you know is, all I know where I am now. Well, I used to be don't have no nothing to do with me. I didn't have him with me then. Now I have him with me. Everything is A-okay. Somebody please say hallelujah. See, if you don't make yourself, won't nobody else do it.
Amen.
Sister Agnes, if you don't do it, folks are just going to walk on you. And they're not the one walking on you. You're walking on yourself. Hallelujah. You put it out there. You better make sure it's tagged by Jesus. If it ain't tagged by Jesus, just keep it to another day. And see what the Lord will do for you. Isaiah, count your many blessings. See what the Lord has done. I said, count your many blessings. See what the Lord has done.
Oh God, and that is to serve you. God, that you will show us our malice ways, oh God. You will show us the things that are wrong, God, in the name of Jesus. So that the mission we're on, God, will be under you, oh God. Under your direction, oh God, and your instructions, oh God. And God, if there's any way that anybody, God, that we have missed and hit, God, with our words, God, in the name of Jesus, that was not becoming for you, oh God. God, that we would turn this around, God, and make it right, God. So the mission, God, would be holy, God, as you call us to be in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you for our family tonight, God. Because, God, it's just not in this house, God. It's to walk on the outside, God, in the name of Jesus. God, and everywhere we go, God, we will spread the news, God. The goodness of your word, God. The goodness of you, oh God. The many things that you've done for us, oh God. We can't even count them all, oh God. We should be sharing, God, in the name of Jesus. But if there's anyone here, God, desire healing, oh God. For your word said, by your stripe, they are healed, oh God. God, we call right now, God, for those, God, who still want to be delivered, God. But God, find themselves walking short, God. Because you're a God of a second chance, oh God. God, and we ask now that deliverance be granted, oh God. And there's someone that's confused, God. There's someone that carries so much burden, God. That God, we ask for peace now in the name of Jesus. But we want to encourage those to hand their burdens over to you, oh God. Because God, they can't do a thing with it, oh God, without your help, God. God, we ask for your anointing, God. That will just edify us, oh God. The Holy Ghost will teach us, oh God. God, we thank you for our leader tonight that has spoke so prophetically, God. That you will pour back into him, God, what he has spoken, oh God. God, that we will allow this word to fall in our hearts and not on deaf ear. God, that's even beginning tonight, God. As we begin the night of Thanksgiving, God. That we will share this word, oh God, in the name of Jesus. That we will talk about you during this holiday season, oh God. We can't even be thankful, God, until we include you first, oh God. And we thank you, we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
It's now time for the ministry of giving.